When he's not racing out on a fire call, Tarpon Springs firefighter Billy Storms pours his heart and his hands into a metal monument to his fellow public servants. It's a replica of the fallen World Trade Center.
I worked off of a few pictures I downloaded and recreated what was left.
From these pictures to this actual beam from the World Trade Center encased inside.
When we first got the beam, everybody touched it and they wanted to feel it because it made it real.
It took several years of emails and phone calls to get the beam, part of a floor joist between towers 1 and 2.
We struck gold, and he is creating history every time he works on this monument.
It's hard to believe where it came from and how this came to be. It really makes you think about the suffering and the loss.
Now, despite this being a labor of love for Storms, the pressure is really on. Time is running out. He only has 3 shifts left to get it all done.
April 27th is my last day here. So it's bittersweet. I love everybody here like their family.
Storm is retiring.
2 spotlights at the bottom, which will shine up on the girder.
That's the real beam. Then there's this ghost beam Storms created, bending stainless steel like Superman.
It resulted in a lot of sore hands. This is an exact replica of this girder.
Framed in wire, the words, "We will never forget."
This is actually a strip of LED lights. It will illuminate this panel here.
And cause the sections to glow at night on this shield-shaped memorial garden.
One in front, one to the back, just like they were sitting in New York.
With the names of people who have given their lives serving the city of Tarpon. All this from a self-taught welder.
I discovered how much I liked working with metal, and from there I just kept doing it.